point, I'm gonna bring on my man John Good. He wrote this poem that we wanna do for y'all. So I think y'all may enjoy it. Where's John Good? Y'all show some love for John Good. Like I said earlier, I've been knowing this brother for quite some time. We've been doing spoken word thing for a little bit. And it works on our patience at times. And are you good?
Yeah.
I'm gonna let him elaborate on that.
Well, thank you, Sphinx. Thank you, brother. I really appreciate it. Yeah, we've been doing Portugal a good little bit, man. Back and forth, broke as hell, broke down the side of 285, 95. After getting our college degrees, I know our parents are proud. It's like, those are my boys, stuck in that van. So, between doing spoken word and poetry, you find this thing of, when you first start writing poems, you just write them because you love to write poetry. And you start making a little bit of money doing it, they start trying to put you on TV, you gotta write these poems because you gotta write them. You find you hate the spoken word thing, you hate it. It's like you're dating these two women. So me and Sphinx wrote this poem, but we looked at poetry and spoken word as these two women you're dating. And you're in love with this poetry thing, but you're cheating on it with this spoken word thing. And so, we wrote this poem, we didn't give it a name, it's called The Poetry Joint, because we are lazy bastards. So, I do believe that this guy, you start this poem?
I think you could.
Fantastic. Are those Diesel or those Ivisu? You shot, dude, at this guy, man.
Damn,
Jesus. I need your check. And shoot, guys, you do what you do. I'm next.
I wish I could say I would have full of love that could be further from the truth.
And honestly, the truth be given, it's like my love affair with spoken word is somewhat like a masochism. It's called a massive gap and schism in my marriage to poetry. I mean, poetry is my heart. And spoken word is like adultery. Like this fatal attraction, it just won't stop calling me.
And I would answer, but I already know what's on the other end. Then she gonna tell me forget about me. When I wanted to let go, she would tell me just hold and pick up another pen. I used to write to her every day, but lately it's just been every now and then. And
every now and again, I wish poetry and I could begin again. Take it back to when it was third spring, yang and yin, weekly people packed in here, spoken words for her yarn. I mean, I walked through the door with poetry on my arm and she was looking damn good. This is before Russell Simmons, Def Jam, and Fan Club, before Seven at the Door, Five with a Can Good.
Because everybody wanted to hear what she had to say. I mean, she had a way of making the whole room quiet. She exposed her soul and the whole room cried. And many men saw her approval, yet walked away denied, and when no one would listen, she supplied the courage that was buried deep inside the archives of my mind, my body, and my soul. This hottie was cold, and when there was pandemonium in my soul, she kept it all under control. But like all relationships, it's getting old and probably starting to take its toll.
And it's taking everything you need not to ask her to leave. Take your similes, hyperboles, and metaphors and hit the door. Leave the keys to the verb. Yes, poetry, I'm leaving you for spoken word, but I have to at least get weekend visitation of our little subjects and predicates, and her nouns are seeming so much less delicate. And my adjectives are seeming somewhat irrelevant. And I adjectives reek with so much anger when we speak, at least my sentences are incomplete. You know, my innocence is displayed on the stage at least once a week, and the strangest thing occurs. Complete strangers leave their seats. Some pat me on the back, some give a little dab. Sometimes tears fall clear from their cheek to their lap. And how am I supposed to react to that? I mean, what do you do when a poem you wrote one night trying to slam your life finally makes it on the mic, and the second you've done, someone calls you to the side like,
dude, I swear to God, everything you just said is like everything I'm going through.
And I didn't even know this dude. I mean, had you been in the room, you wouldn't have even noticed, dude. He said,
all I know is true, that there's power in your words and somehow salvation in what you do.
And I told him thank you. But there's no need to thank me, feel free to thank poetry, for you see, it was she who sat for 9 months with this poem in her womb. She earthed it through me, but she earthed it for you.
He even knew about this woman in my head who held the only screw. He saw the beauty in the vivid pictures she drew. I'm saying, we exchanged a few words, and over time those sentences grew.
In the paragraphs I paraphrased, but spoken words paralleled the printed page. I stood perpendicular to the center stage and spoke of poetry conceived in the splinter days, and the dark tonight is winter raged, and born in the light when God raised his head to say, let there be light. Darkness he ran, but poetry she stayed.
Even in the presence of God, she wasn't afraid. We never married, but remained engaged in this verbal masquerade. She spoke to older men, brothers half my age.
Brothers dead broken, brothers halfway paid. She's looking so good these days, everybody's trying to date and do her. BET
tried to rape her.
HBO.
They tried to screw her.
But I'm the defender of her chastity, and that's how it has to be. I'm her proclamation to the nation saying that she's with me. A cradle robber because she hollered at me in my infancy. But even as a child, I knew poetry and how it meant to be. And you can call it what you like, spoken word or open mic. And you get captured in a rapture on a Broadway stage over the night. But once the night done ended,
and the mic is left winded,
and the tears die down,
over all these years I have found,
whether it's New York,
LA,
Atlanta,
or DC,
whether it's the stage,
the page,
radio,
or TV,
at the end of the night poetry, she always comes home to me.
At the end of the night poetry, always comes home with me.
Give it up for the fans, y'all, doing his thing.